Hey y'all, and welcome to a What I Eat in a Day 1 month postpartum, breastfeeding around the clock my 1 month old daughter. So my calorie needs are super high. If you didn't know, breastfeeding requires even more calories than when you were pregnant, so you should actually be increasing your calories once you have the baby. When we are pregnant, we lose 10% of our mineral store, so restoring that in the postpartum season is vital to avoid lots of those postpartum issues that many mamas face. So you will see what I eat today is very simple, but mineral rich, whole foods, easy to put together, but super delicious. So let's jump right into the foods. I started out with some savory oats. I soaked my oats overnight in raw milk and a little bit of water. And in the morning, I just strained the excess milk and cooked the oats in bone broth. So this bone broth was super gelatinous. You can see how jiggly it is. This is the preferred way you want your bone broth to look. Now I'll admit, mine does not always look this way, but when I started adding chicken feet to my bone broth, it has gotten so much more gelatinous, which makes it that much more nutritious for you. I also cooked them with a little bit of salt and let them get really, really thick and cooked before I added a splash of milk, some raw butter, let them cook a little bit longer. The longer you cook them, the more thick and rich they'll get. And then to spice this up, I was going for a savory sweet taste today. So I added a bit of clove and cinnamon and then a little bit of honey. You could also add cheese instead of the honey if you wanted to keep it that savory taste instead of adding the little bit of sweet. And then I topped it off with a poached egg. This is absolutely delicious. I think y'all will like this combination. We normally have sweet oats, like with maple syrup or honey or fruit, but these savory oats are a delicious way to change it up. Lately, I've been loving having orange juice mixed with raw milk, and that seems like an odd combination, but it's really just like an orange creamsicle, those popsicles that we all used to eat growing up. Absolutely delicious. Amazing breakfast. Try this one out.
Coffee, iced coffee. I had breakfast with my husband when he left, and then the kids got up and I sat with them for breakfast, and they're playing or wanting to help me, and I'm gonna make a yolk of coffee. So it's actually really important not to drink coffee on an empty stomach. I'm just whipping together an egg yolk from our backyard chicken, so I know what these chickens have been fed, how they are raised. I would not trust using egg yolks from like the grocery store because you don't actually know the raising process of those chickens. Do you want a Hulkster? Anyways, I've made this many times on this channel, but I never actually whipped, like truly whipped the egg yolk. And you do want to whip it for that perfect texture. It's gonna taste delicious. Let's not eat that yet. Let's make our yolky coffee. The more you whip it though, the more delicious, creamy it's gonna make your coffee.
Tenderjewel is helping me make this. I'll chat with y'all just a minute about caffeine. Caffeine is commonly classified as like the enemy in our mainstream culture, but I don't believe that's so. It's only harmful when it's taken by itself on an empty stomach without the right proper nutrients mixed with it, or if your body's already in a chronic stress state. The most common reason people experience jitters and other unwanted symptoms is due to malnourishment from their other food sources. Their adrenals are stressed or they have low thyroid function. Also, improperly preparing your coffee, drinking it black, fasted, or on empty stomach is also not the recipe for success. When you do coffee the right way, you should feel a sense of calmness, focus, motivation, warmth, and stable energy. However, when you do coffee wrong, you may have the feeling of anxiety, shakiness, sweatiness, weird feelings, and the inability to focus. All I'm really stressing here is don't do coffee on an empty stomach. Mix it with proper nutrients and let it help you instead of hinder you. All right, I'll take y'all back to making the coffee with Tenderjewel now.
Really thick. And when you pour, it kind of slowly runs off that spoon. It's not quite so runny. We are making iced coffee, so I'm going to pour over our coffee. Maybe top it with raw milk. If you're making this a warm coffee, you would want to warm your milk, froth it up a little. It's so delicious that way too.
Thank y'all.
Yeah. left is pretty much always leftovers. We don't have much leftovers from last night. And I'm gonna have a warm glass of bone broth. So I'm gonna get this warming.
But we had some leftover venison pot pie. I just slow cooked a venison backstrap in the slow cooker. And then that night mixed it with some carrots, celery, lots of broth. And then made a pie crust for the bottom and the top. Added a large slice of sourdough bread with some butter. I wanted to talk just a minute to y'all about sourdough and why it's so important to ferment or sprout your grains. The main reason is because the untreated phytic acid in grains can combine with other minerals in the intestinal tract and block their absorption. So all those minerals I always am talking about, if we're not properly fermenting our grains, all those minerals can bind with the phytic acid and cause them to not properly absorb, which the whole point of making sure our mineral take is in check is that our body is properly absorbing them. Just about every European meal begins with sourdough bread and butter, which was considered essential for good health and digestion. A full cup of bone broth can usually add about 10 grams of protein, which honestly was shocking to me. I didn't realize bone broth could have that much protein in it, but it truly is another superfood that we love in our home. We love it for soups, we love it for casseroles, we love it for hot chocolate, we love to drink it plain. So I just paired my lunch today with a small cup of bone broth.
It's delicious.
Before our afternoon snack, I like to consume my raw carrot salad on an empty stomach so all of the minerals are properly absorbed. To make the raw carrot salad, I just have chopped up or shredded, chopped, grated, however you want to prepare it. One carrot with about half of an apple. The apple just complements the flavor and adds a little bit of sweetness. And then for the dressing on your carrot salad, it's just a half teaspoon of apple cider vinegar, a teaspoon of honey, a little pinch of salt, and about a half teaspoon of coconut oil, all mixed together. Tossed in the carrots and the apples, so delicious. You can also add ginger or raisins. There's many add-ins you can add. All carrots have unique fibers in them that help them to detox excess estrogen in the body and keep our endotoxin load low. If you don't care about all the science behind this, just know that the raw carrot salad helps detox the body from excess estrogen, and excess estrogen is the underlying cause for so many problems, especially in women. Especially in the postpartum season, pregnancy season, just keeping that estrogen level in check is so important, and a raw carrot salad is one of the easiest ways to do that. Just a bit of yogurt left, not enough to actually enjoy a bowl of yogurt, which I often do, but it was enough to make some tarka, an ancient probiotic that restores the intestinal flora. So all it is one part yogurt and four parts water, blended up, milky yogurt drink. It's absolutely delicious. I topped it with some cinnamon, cumin, and a pinch of salt. So delicious, so healing, and just a little simple treat here to tide me over until dinner. Also very simple, y'all. Most of our meals are pretty simple and basic around here. We just pull staple ingredients together and make delicious, nourishing meals out of them. So like I had mentioned before, I had slow cooked a venison backstrap in our crock pot the previous day. So I marinated the venison in some butter, garlic, and onions just to give it a good flavor. It was already so flavorful from being cooked in the crock pot, but just to kind of change the flavors for our dinner tonight. And then had soaked some rice starting the previous evening, and it was ready to strain and cook. I always cook our rice in bone broth. If you are not cooking your rice in bone broth, you're truly missing out, not only for the flavor that it provides, but also just the nutritional benefits, because I already mentioned to y'all how much of a staple bone broth is in our house. So the trick to cooking rice is to use double the amount of broth that you do rice. So if you're using one cup of rice, do 2 cups of bone broth. Put it in the in a pot, cover it, and let it set for 25 minutes. Don't touch it. It becomes out perfectly every time. You're cooking this over a medium to low heat. So slow cooking it, it comes out perfect every single time. I used to always mess up rice and it would either be too crunchy or it would stick or burn, but this is the absolute trick to cooking the perfect rice. And then I made a little simple bone broth gravy. Used some bone broth, a little bit of flour, butter, whipped it up into a thick roux. Let it simmer, and then covered our rice and venison with that bone broth gravy. For the side, just had some steamed carrots from the Instant Pot, tossed in butter, a little bit of rosemary and garlic and salt, and called it a delicious dinner. Again, meals do not have to be fancy, y'all. You can just pull a few simple ingredients together and put together a beautiful, nourishing, wholesome meal for your family.